Hello everyone and welcome to this Pokemon Reborn Nuzlocke guide. I've been playing Pokemon Reborn for about 7 years now, or 8 or something, and I'm really skilled at Nuzlocking it because I know basically everything there is to know about this game. And I know a lot of tips and tricks, so I'm going to share some with you today. How to beat Sarah 100% of the time are really easy. All you need is a Wurmadam Trash with Miracoat and of Mirror Shot, excuse me, and Quiver Dance, because Mirror Shot in the Mirror Arena becomes a 130 base power move with a guaranteed accuracy, just like moves like Aerial Ace. It will always hit, and it's obviously a steel type move. And I put a metronome on him. You can buy a metronome in the mart, in the giant mart, at the fourth floor, I think. There are three chances for you to get a Burmy, you can also encounter other things in the trees where you can get Burmy, but Burmy also has to be female. So there is a chance that you won't even get a Burmy then, that would suck. But there are three chances, and I got it the second try. And I'm really happy about it, because I'm now going to show you why this threat works so good. I'm all ready. Let's go. She leads with a Glaceon, which can't really touch me at all. So all you really need to do is set up a bunch of Quiver Dances. That's one. And that's two. And that's three. You do gotta watch out for them crits though, I was just about to say. But thankfully I bought some berry ice cream. Normally my Nuzlocke, I wouldn't use healing items in battle, but for games like when we wanna make an exception, because it's otherwise it's just not fun for me. And you, in a Nuzlocke, you just have to make it fun for yourself. So whatever rules work for you, you live by those. Anyway, this is a pretty standard Nuzlocke. And all that. Glaceon loves quitting. But also quitting has a higher chance here, because if you up your evasion and or accuracy, your this thing will follow. Okay, this is a pretty bad timing, because now he has Aurora Veil has just been set up. Let's see, we have super potions. So that's a really bad timing, because I don't know if the Aurora Veil has to be down. But I'll waste some super potions in any case. He really loves quitting. Yeah, the accuracy, evasion, the crit chance thing is kind of obvious, yeah. Yep. Okay, there it is again, but it won't really matter. Soon, I think I'm just going to start attacking, because I don't think it matters at all. Mirror shots, cool animation, okay. That's one. Sand slash, okay. Mirror shots. And that's two. Frost slash. This also has a bunch of evasion stuff, but it doesn't matter because Mirror Shot always hits, because it's the Mirror Arena. So, also Nature Power, if you don't have Wurmadam, Nature Power also turns into Mirror Shot. So you can really use Nature Power to your advantage here, if you have some other Pokémon that you want to use. I obviously brought 5 other Pokémon just in case, but you really only need Wurmadam Trash. Make sure it evolves into Wurmadam Trash, so just train it in the city, and your Burmy will transform into the pink one, then evolve it, and you'll have a Wurmadam Trash. It gets Quiver Dance at level 20, so it actually has some in-game, early game use as well, because Quiver Dance is just a really amazing move. I really like that they gave Mofim and Wurmadam Quiver Dance level 20, because it makes them somewhat viable. Also, you get Bug Buzz at level 50, and Mirror Shot somewhere in the 20s, 30s, I don't remember. But make sure you keep Mirror Shot, because it gets Iron Head later, but you don't want Iron Head. But I am now going to show you where you can encounter the Burmese, so stay tuned for that. Alright, so one important thing about getting a Burmy is that you need Headbutt, because they're only in Headbutt trees. The easiest way to get Headbutt is with the 6 Dragoon you can get here. It could also be a Pachirisu, so that would suck. But these two, these three guys are bullying the 6 Dragoon, and you can get it here and hit Nose Headbutt, get it set at level like 11. If you don't get the 6 Dragoon, you can also may get a Snubbull. which also knows Headbutt, but that also might be a Stuffle, which doesn't know Headbutt. So if you get Stuffle and Pachirisu, then you should reset this game, because I don't really know where else you could get Headbutt easily. But maybe there probably are other ways to get it. The first place you can get a Burmy is in this tree. You will be giving up your encounter otherwise, but if you encounter something like a Pineco, always catch it, because in all trees where you get Burmy, there's also Pineco, so you may want to make sure you get Dupescrawl from that. The next option is Barrel Ward. You can get a Burmy in this tree. And the third option is actually right next to this one, because here, this tree and this tree is actually in a different area. So this is the Barrel Cemetery, so you can also get a Burmy here. So those are three options where you can get a Burmy. Make sure it's female, because Motim is pretty useless. Except Motim you can trade for a Trapinch, so that's really cool. But Trapinch or Motim or Flygon, they won't beat Sarah, so you want a Wormadam Trash. Thanks for watching, I hope this helped. If you have other questions or other guides you might want about a Pokemon Reborn Nuzlocke, you can ask about them in the comments. I also might upload more guides, I probably will, because I really like playing this game and Nuzlocking it. Thanks for watching, goodbye.